Friends, welcome ourselves to today's Eucharistic celebration. Today's homily I titled it, Let Your Light Shine. Let Your Light Shine. And seeing in the first reading, apostles and Christians multiplying in number, I could picture the apostles just beckoning on everyone saying, come together, come together, come together in Jesus' name. Jesus, people, come together, let your light shine. Share your love with one another, let your light shine. Let no difference grow between you, let your light shine. Let no difference grow between you, let your light shine. Oh, let it shine, shine, shine. Come on now, let your light shine. Oh, let it shine, shine, shine. Come on. The power of the resurrection is the power of light. The power that opens the door for all of us. As I said last Sunday, the last 2 weekends was a bad weekend for the apostles. The weekend that they abandoned Jesus Christ. The weekend of passion. The weekend of pain. The weekend of loneliness for Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ hanging on the cross said, it is finished. It is finished. I won the race for you. I fought a good fight for you. I died for your own sake. Jesus Christ was buried and people thought that was the end. But on the third day, he resurrected. Well, Jesus Christ resurrected, and that is the reason why we are celebrating Easter. We are celebrating the Hallelujah, the light. But even last Sunday, I mean, it was last Friday, in the Gospel, St. Peter said, I'm going fishing. No, he has never said that for the past 3 years because I've been walking with Jesus Christ. All of a sudden, Jesus Christ died, resurrected for them. Maybe they have lost their job. They said, let's go back to our former job. Let's go fishing. And while fishing, they spent the whole night. They caught nothing. And in the morning, suddenly Jesus Christ appeared and said, friends, have you caught anything? And they said, no, we spent the whole night, we caught nothing. Jesus Christ said to them, now, cast your net for a catch. They said, but we spent the whole night, we didn't catch anything. Is it now in the morning that we'll catch something? But in faith, they did. And immediately, the net became a magnet. Fish came from everywhere. They hauled the fish into the boat. Jesus Christ said, come and have your breakfast. That particular scenario reminds us that in times of difficulties that Jesus Christ will always be with us. Remind us of what happened in the book of John. And apart from me, you can do nothing. They spent the whole night, they never called on Jesus Christ. But once Jesus Christ showed up, everything changed. The miracle occurred. The impossible became possible. And so we are encouraged. And the presence of Jesus Christ, the power of the resurrection, brings healing, brings protection, answers our prayers. And and still gripped in fear, they locked the house. Jesus Christ showed up again. The second time I said, peace be with you. I don't know how you would feel. Maybe you've lost your loved one and they are just in the house, still in pain. You lock every place and suddenly the person shows up and says, don't fear me. He said, peace be with you. I am here for you. And he said, as the Father has sent me, so I am sending you. Go and preach. As the Father has sent Jesus Christ, and Jesus Christ sending out the apostles, we too have been sent out. Think of your own vocation, the way you have been called. It reminds us that on the last day, we will stand before God to give the account of our stewardship. Because we have been sent. Remember, St. Paul was sent, St. Peter was sent, the rest of the apostles were sent. And St. Paul ran the race till they finished. And he said, I have finished the race. I have fought the good fight. I have kept the good faith. What is left for me now is a crown of heaven. Do you realize that you have been sent? And every call goes with its own many difficulties, pain, sorrow, and cross. Jesus Christ said, here I am, Lord, send me. He answered the call for the cross following. And so as Jesus Christ has sent out the apostles, he has sent all of us. And the fruit of that sending manifested in the first reading of today. For the apostles and the Christians that heard the message, the sick, the lame, the blind, the deaf, the dumb, they were brought to the presence of the apostles and they were being healed. The coming together of the Christians and the apostles manifested the corporal works of mercy in practice. Feeding the hungry, the thirsty. Sheltering the homeless. Visiting the sick. The imprisoned. Burying the dead. And so as we have been called, let us know that we are brothers and sisters. And let us live the life that the apostles and the rest of the Christians live today. Sharing whatever they had with one another. And that brings us into the next message, the divine mercy, which we are celebrating today, giving to St. Faustina in 1930. Jesus Christ appeared before St. Faustina. And St. Faustina saw this image, the hand of Jesus Christ touching his heart and raising the right hand, blessing the people. And he saw the light rays, one gray and the other one white. And he said, present this image to the world. Present this image to the world. Many people doubted her, but she persisted until April 30th, 2000, Pope John Paul II, now St. John Paul II, canonized St. Faustina, and equally established that day, saying that every Sunday following Easter Sunday will be known as Divine Mercy Sunday. And this water and blood We are coming from the heart of Jesus Christ to show the love that Jesus Christ has for all of us. And beneath the image of Jesus Christ is this signature: Jesus, I trust in you. Jesus, I trust in you. Jesus said, whenever you say these words, I will be with you. As we are called, as the apostles we are called, sometimes we have our own crosses, we have our own pain, we have our own difficult moments. When those moments come, remember that you have been called. When those difficult moments come, remember to say these words: Jesus, I trust in you. And when you say these words, Jesus Christ will make the impossible possible. Remember, the apostles spent the whole night fishing. They caught nothing. But once Jesus Christ showed up, everything changed. Call on Jesus Christ today. Present your crosses, your pain, your sorrow, your difficulties before Him. And don't forget to say, Jesus, I trust in you. When you are in your sick bed, when you see the tears running down on your cheek, say, Jesus, I trust in you. And the hand that Jesus Christ is raising on this image will be upon you and renew the life, so that your life begins to shine again. Because the power of resurrection is the power of life. Oh, let it shine, shine, shine. Come on and let your